In this video, I'll be explaining how to use Google Sheets. So let's go ahead and give this assignment a name, and we'll call it Google Sheets Basics. What we'll be able to do by the end of this video is we'll be able to use some basic formulas such as add and subtract, divide, multiply. We'll be able to use a few shortcuts as well when it comes to this. So when using Google Sheets, if you notice on here that there's a line of numbers that are along here, and there's a line of letters that are up here. So whenever you click on a cell, it identifies right away where that cell is located when it comes to this. When we enter in formula lines, they'll be where you see the FX would be in there. So if you were typing in your name or whatever it is, and if you need to go back and change something, instead of hitting the back or the delete button, it would delete the entire cell. So what you would have to do, the formula line, edit it up there, and then make your changes when it comes to this. Google Sheets is nice because you can put a lot of formulas in. It can do a lot of heavy lifting when it comes to being able to add and subtract and put statistics together. So it's good information to be known. All right, so let's figure out what are some basic shortcuts that you can use when it comes to Google Sheets. So what we're going to do is we're going to click and combine four of these cells together. And I'll do the best I can to zoom in so you can see what we're doing here. We're going to click and combine four cells together. And then we're going to go up to Format. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go to Merge Cells and Merge All. And when we do that, it's now it's its own entire cell. And we're going to call this Basic Shortcuts. And the key, especially when you're using Google Sheets, is to stay organized and neat. So what we want to do is center the title. And then let's put some borders around it, which the button's right here for borders. And now we have that ready. So what we're going to do underneath this is we're going to click and these two cells here, and we're going to merge these together. So these two here, Format, Merge Cells, Merge All. And then what we want to do is we want to duplicate that cell. So whenever you click on a cell, you'll notice that there is a box in the bottom right-hand corner of that cell. So if you click and drag, and when we click and drag, it duplicates whatever's inside that cell. So we duplicated this entire thing, and then we're going to click and highlight these cells, and then we're going to drag it over, and now we have different columns here. So now we're going to put borders around all of this. Again, keeping it nice and organized. So first shortcut is Command. Want to type in is Command plus X. And these are quite universal when it comes to using anything Google. A lot of these can be used in Microsoft as well. Microsoft Word, Excel spreadsheets, things like that. So these are basic shortcuts that you could use to help yourself navigate better and be able to move quicker when it comes to Google Sheets. All right, so Command X, Command C, Z, Y, and V. If you're using a Windows computer, instead of the word Command, you would use Control plus the letter and it would do the same thing. So Command X means to cut, Command C is to copy, Command Z is undo, Command Y is redo, and paste is Command V. And let's center all these as well. So now we have some basic shortcuts here. All right, let's start putting some formulas together. So we're going to click and we're going to merge. Let's go 8 across. Let's go to Format. Merge cells, merge all. And we're going to call this one basic formulas. We're going to center it. And then we're going to change the font size to 25. And let's also put a border around this one. All right, so the first formula that we're going to look at is we're going to how to add. So let's click and highlight on four cells, merge those again, and we'll call this how to. Before we do that, let's duplicate this. So drag it down. We're going to call this how to add. And the symbol that we're using for add is the plus button. And let's keep this centered. And let's change out the font to 20. So how to add. So we're just going to put a couple numbers in here. Let's go 8, 7. And what we want the spreadsheet to do is add these up. Oh, let's put borders around this as well. And you know what? Let's give how to add a background color. So if we go to the fill color, which is the paint bucket, and give it a color. So now we now can distinguish easier what all these basic formulas are. All right, so we got two cells. We got 8 in one, and we got 7 in another one. We want to add those together. Whenever we start a formula in Google Sheets, is we always start with the equal sign. And as we enter in the formula, it will be up here in the formula line. So equals, go equals, click on the first number you put down. Then we're going to do the plus sign, and you notice here in the formula line, it's adding it there for us. And then we're going to click on the second cell, and when we hit enter or return, it'll automatically do it for us. Now what's nice about this, it remembers the formula. So if you're clicking around, and if you click on a cell that has a formula, that means it's in there, and you don't have to change anything. So if I change this number to 10, it'll automatically switch with me. So it doesn't matter what it is, it will continue to add up for whatever we need. All right, let's try another formula. Let's try how to subtract. So let's click on how to add and the plus button. Let's copy it, Command C. And right next to it, let's put it in here. But instead of how to add, let's go how to subtract. Now, if the cell is too long, or what we're putting into the cell is too long, all we need to do is switch out the font to make sure it fits. And instead of the plus sign, we will do the subtract sign. All right. So let's try it out. 8, 7. Again, to start a formula, go to the equal sign first. Click on the 8. Do the subtract sign. Click on the 7. Enter. Does it for us. As you can see, whatever we put in there, it'll do it for us. Even if it's below 0, it'll automatically do the negative sign for us as well. So let's change this color so we stay a little organized when it comes to that. All right, next one. Again, copy paste these two. This one, we're going to do how to multiply. And the symbol for this one is the star or the asterisk. And where you'd find that is where you look at the number 8. Now, in order to get that, we have to hold down Shift and then press 8, and now we have the asterisk there for us. So let's try one out. We'll stick with 8 and 7. And let's go equals, click on the 8. Now let's do the multiplication symbol, which is the star, which is Shift 8. Click on 7, enter 56. And again, you're doing large numbers. Oh, too many numbers. It does it for you, which is really nice, especially if you're doing data entry. All right, let's move on. Let's do how to divide. And the symbol used for this is the backslash. And you'd find that where you would have your question mark for that. So let's go 8 and 2. We're going to go equals 8 divided by 2. And again, the formula is right here. Enter does it for us. If it's a decimal, it calculates the decimal for you. So again, it's really nice when it comes to this, be able to do these things. Let's change out the colors on these as well, so we can see the difference. We'll go from there. All right, so now we can add, we can subtract, we can multiply, and now we can divide. What about if we have, well, let's show two more things before we get to that. So let's copy and paste this again. But this time, let's show you some other things that you need to know when using these different spreadsheets. So I guess we wouldn't need this cell at all. So if we just copy blank cells, paste it in there, we're good to go there. And let's do a color. So we stay nice and organized. All right. So we're going to demonstrate the currency button, and also we're going to demonstrate the percentage button. So let's say I have 6 in here. I want that to be $6. And all you need to do is go up into the toolbar, click on the currency button, which is the dollar sign, and it does it for you. Percentage, same thing. Go up here to the percent button, click on it, and it'll automatically do it for you. So if we want 5%, we just put 5 in there, and it does it for us, which is nice. All right, let's try a few more formulas here. So let's say that we want to add up a whole bunch of numbers, and we're doing a data entry. We need to find the most amount when it comes to a certain amount of points that we need. So we need to know how to find the total sum. And the key word we'll be using for this is sum. So let's say we have 8, 7, 5, and let's just go with that. We could go equals, click on the first cell, plus sign, click on the second cell, plus sign, third cell, but that'd be a lot of work when it comes to this, and Google Sheets is all about finding the shortcuts. So we want to go equals, but instead of clicking on each cell, we could type in sum, S-U-M, enter, and then we can click and drag on top of all the cells we want to add up and press enter, and it does it for us. So we could change these out, whatever we want them to be. It does it for us. So sum is really a nice one to use. What about average? What if we want to find the average of a certain amount of numbers? So let's change that out, how to find average. And the word we'll actually type in is average as well. All right, so let's say I have 8, 7, 5. We want to find the average of those three numbers. Equal sign again. Type in average, enter, and then click and drag on the three cell or whatever cells you want. And the average for this one is 6.6. And if we change out the numbers to be what we want them to be, it'll take care of it for us as well, which is really nice. Now, if you notice, when I was typing in the word average, a bunch of words came up here. And what Google Sheets does, it automatically keeps track of all the different words or all the different shortcuts when it comes to this. Let's say you're in a cell and you made a mistake and you want to go back. If you haven't clicked out of it yet, if you just hit the escape key, it acts as if nothing ever happened. Okay? So, how to average. Let's do a couple more. Copy and paste. Let's how to find largest number. The key word we'll use for this is max. Okay, so let's just use 8, 7, and 5. And let's say we need to find out what is the maximum number out of this group of numbers. So we could do equals first, click and drag over the three cells. Oops, MAX, enter. And it'll automatically spit out the highest number. So if the numbers change, it will also change with us. So once you have the formula in, it is so nice to be able just to go back, put in new numbers, and it does it for you. All right, moving on. Well, if we found the largest number, what we need to look for now is how to find the minimum number. So how to find the lowest number. And this is called min, M-I-N, or minimum. So let's try it. 875 equals M-I-N. Enter, click on your cells, and there you go. If it changes, changes with it. So it's kind of cool. All right, so let's do a little bit of practice here with these formulas just to make sure we got them down. So let's scroll down a little bit more, and let's say we're doing statistics for some basketball players. And let's merge some of these cells together. And we'll call this basketball roster. And we want to add, let's just add four players. So we can copy this cell down. And again, let's put borders around all of this. And also let's center it. Let's say we have John, Joe, Jake, Jr. And let's say that we have the statistics for game 1, game 2, game 3, game 4, game 5. Let's just add the borders right away. Let's center it all. And now, let's just start making some numbers. So we got 10, 12, 11, 45, 25, 25, 5, and 2, 4, 9, 45, 12, 6, 8, 21, 36, and game 5, 35, 4, 1, and 99. Okay. So now we have the amount of points for the entire team. What we need to find is the total amount from each player. So we can type in total, click and drag this, borders, center it, and we want to find the total amount of points per player. So as we did before, we're going to use the formula for sum. So equals, S-U-M, enter. Click and highlight for each of those games. Enter, 80 points. Now, we could do that for each player, but instead of doing that, if we click on the little box in the bottom right-hand corner, it'll duplicate that, and it'll automatically do it for us, saving us a good amount of time. So that's total. What about highest points, lowest points, and average? So let's center these, order them, and let's find the highest amount of points. So let's use the formula again, max. So